This lecture will explain how to create a bada application. Since creating a complex bada application is not yet possible for us, I will create an application by adding a few functions to the source code created by the template. First, I will explain the structure and the mechanism of the application and show you the template code. Then I will explain a basic UI and the app namespace. To create an application, you first need to know about the application framework and the application model. Therefore, in this lecture, I will explain the application framework, in particular the application model, the application lifecycle, and an event loop. And then we will look at the source code created by the template in more detail. After that, I will explain UI development, such as adding a UI, assigning an event to a UI control, and handling events. And then I'll explain the OSP app functions. Applications running on the bada platform can be classified as either base applications or bada applications. Base applications refer to conventional phone applications that support functions, such as making a call and sending an SMS. Bada applications refer to applications that can be installed through the web and removed from the phone. An important thing you should remember is that only one bada application runs at a time. More than one bada application cannot run simultaneously. Of course, a bada application can run at the same time as a base application. This performs an important role in the bada application lifecycle. Let's take a look at the bada application lifecycle in more detail. Like other applications, a bada application has initialization procedures when the application starts, and termination procedures when the program finishes. Between the initialization and termination of the application, a base application such as answering a call may need to be executed. In this case, the bada application runs in the background, and if the base application is terminated, the bada application returns to running in the foreground. While the bada application is running, an event loop occurs in the framework. The bada framework works on the basis of events, in the same way as other widely used frameworks. An application transfers control to the system after the initialization process. Then the event loop runs within the system, checking events. And if an event occurs, the system delivers the event to the application so that the application can handle the event. Let's take a look at the application lifecycle in more detail. All bada applications are created as subclasses of the application class of OSP app. In the subclass, if the application is launched, the onApp initialization function is called. In this function, the application performs the initialization, and if the initialization is successfully completed, the onForeground function of the application is called. If a situation occurs where the application needs to run in the background, the onBackground function of the application is called. If the application returns to the foreground, the onForeground function is called. When the application needs to be terminated, the onAppTerminating function is called. Therefore, you can precisely manage the application lifecycle. Therefore, you can precisely manage the application lifecycle by inserting the appropriate code into the application. Let's look into the situation when an application is launched in more detail. When an application is launched, the main entry point function, OSP main, in the application name entry.cpp is called. The procedures to initialize the application class are included in this function. When this application class is initialized, the onAppInitializing function in the application class is called. The onAppInitializing function is a virtual function of the application class and is overridden in the app.cpp file. Therefore, to create an application, you have to implement the initialization procedures in this function. An application is terminated by one of the following four cases. If an application calls the terminate function directly, the application is terminated. If the user presses the end key, the application is terminated. If the user runs another bada application, the existing bada application is terminated, because again, only one bada application can run at a time on the bada platform. If the available memory becomes extremely low, the system terminates the bada application. If the available memory becomes extremely low, the system terminates the bada application. In these cases, the onAppTerminating virtual function of the application class is called. This function can also be found in the application_name.cpp file. You have to implement the code to properly terminate the application in this function. If the user presses the home button or a call arrives when a bada application is running, the base application should have top priority and the bada application changes to run in the background. This means the screen is not displayed. In this case, the system calls the onBackground function of the application class. In this function, any operations necessary for when the application enters the background state are performed. For example, if there is a continuously running process, such as an animation, timer, or multimedia process, the process should be stopped and any unnecessary resources should be released. If the situation changes and the bada application should be run in the foreground, the onForeground function is called. In the onForeground function, any procedures to resume the continuous processes that were stopped in the onBackground function and to allocate the necessary resources should be performed. Next, this diagram shows the application status transition between the foreground and the background. If an application is launched, the application's entry point, OSP main, is called, and OSP main executes the application. There is a part in the execute function that calls the initialize function, and the initialize function calls the onAppInitializing function. Then, since the frame corresponding to the window of the application has appeared on top of the screen as the next step, the onForeground function is called. After the onForeground function is called, the system runs an event loop to check for events. If a situation to switch the application to the background while the event loop is running occurs, the onBackground function of the application is called. If the application should run in the foreground again, the onForeground function is called. Finally, the terminate function of the application framework is called. The terminate function calls the onAppTerminating in the application, and the application is terminated. As I mentioned briefly, this application lifecycle is implemented using the OSP App Application class. We call the OSP App Application class the application class for short. This application class is the base class for every bada application. Every application has to inherit the application class. Since the state transition, system event handling, and user event handling functions are virtual functions in the application class, you can create the application by implementing these functions appropriate to the application. Additionally, in the application class, functions are implemented to get the application name, the application version, the application registry information, the resources, the main UI frame, and the current application state. Now, let's have a look at the functions in the application class in more detail. First, the functions to get the application state or information are implemented, such as the getAppName, getAppVersion, getAppRegistry, getAppResource, getAppState, and getAppFrame functions. The sendUserEvent function to generate a user event is implemented. To terminate an application from within the application, you can use the terminate function. Within this application class, a few virtual functions are defined. Since state transition related virtual functions and system or user event related virtual functions are defined, you can develop an application by implementing the functions. For more detail, the state transition related virtual functions are onAppInitializing, onAppTerminating, onBackground, and onForeground. The system and user event handling virtual functions are onBatteryLevelChanged, which is called when the battery is low, onLowMemory, which is called when the available memory is low, onScreenOnOff, which are called when the screen is turned on or off, and onUserEventReceivedN, which is called when a user event occurs.